Hey, you guys. Let's do lunch. I'm so excited. I can't see straight. Yes. Chicken and dumplings on the menu today. River Chick 23. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I ordered this from Dollar Tree online. You have to order it by the case, and then shipping was $8, so I spent $28. If I'd gone in store, obviously only $12. But here's the kicker: I'm not guaranteed that every time I go to our Dollar Tree, they're gonna have it. Number one, number two. The $8 is well worth my time to just have it delivered and not spend the time going to get it. My first can. Oh, I have just as many fun stories as I do cans of dumplings. Oh, River Chick, you are a gem of a viewer. Thank you again. And you know, I had known you could order it online, I think like a year or so ago, when I first got addicted to this can of dumplings. And you see, the green olives obviously don't come with the dumplings. I added it. I'm craving green olives. The other thing I'm craving over here are these fresh basil leaves. I might as well just put them in now. And side note, fresh basil helps eliminate mucus and stuffiness from your system, just FYI. Where was I? What was I talking about? I got so excited. Oh my goodness. Well, maybe it'll come back to me. Or maybe I wasn't even talking about something. I don't remember. Well, on with the story time. Did you guys know I had a terrible speech impediment as a child? I had to go to a special class for tutoring to say my S's. I was like Cindy Brady. Remember the Cindy Brady show? Baby talk, baby talk. It's a wonder you can walk or something. She had a... Cindy Brady had a speech. Had a, I don't know what you call it when you can't say your S's. But all my life, I kind of had forgotten about it. It was like in first or second grade. It was very stressful for me because they would either take me out of... I either had to have my class after school with a nice young lady who was my therapist. It was private tutoring at school. But she was always trying to find a room where we could go, and then we'd be in this huge room all by ourselves doing it. And as a little kid, I'm pretty sure it was like first grade, that was spooky for me. Nothing about the therapist was spooky. It was just real quiet, huge classroom, and it's just me and her. And the fact that it was an odd time, either after school, it was pretty quiet, so I'm thinking it was after school, possibly during recess, but I think mainly after school. And I was doing all these things with my S's. Then I had to have homework, and I was really nervous, wondering, well, what if I can't do it right? And I come back and I still have my problem. Stressful. Okay, life goes on. I totally forget about it. So, the Brady Bunch comes along, and Cindy, they have a whole show about her. I can't say her S's. And even when she came to the show and she couldn't say her S's, I didn't even notice it till they highlighted it on the show, and there's a little boy teasing her. All I can remember, baby talk, it's a wonder. You know what haunted me? All those memories came back. I'd totally forgotten I had that problem. It all came back. So I was in grammar school in the late 60s. When Brady Bunch came out. But I remember when it came on, reliving all those thoughts. And the other thought that was, I was so sure, those of you who remember, I remember the story I told you, I chipped my tooth in like kindergarten or first grade. No, it had been around the same time, first grade. I chipped my front tooth. I didn't know I had a speech problem. So when they explained to me I had a speech problem, I had to go to this special class by myself because nobody in the school needed it. My mom's telling me, "Oh, don't worry about it." Everybody has it, it's not a big deal. In my mind, it was a big deal. I was convinced that it was because of that chipped tooth. Now, I have this funny, it's a lisp, that's what it is. A lisp, that's it. I'm so into these dumplings. I apologize, you guys. I'm not even seeing the camera. I'm sorry. So, as a kid, I'm thinking, oh my gosh, if I would have never chipped my tooth, I'd never have this problem with my S's. Oh, it was like a huge, vicious circle. Me thinking all these negative thoughts. My mom kept saying, "It's not that big a deal. You don't have to go there forever. You'll do just fine." But then when it was just a spooky in a quiet room with, it just seemed like everything echoed, and then I had to do homework, just seemed like it magnifies in your mind. That, of course, years went on. I forgot about, but all bigger than beans, Cindy Brady comes back with a lisp. I'm reliving the horror of my lisping as a child. And if you notice, and I notice it, and I don't know how to not do it till after it happens. If you listen closely to my videos, when I say something that starts with an S, oh my goodness, it's almost as if I'm whistling. The S is like such, so perfect. And I don't think S's were meant to be that perfect to where it sounds like you're gonna have a whistle. But maybe you guys don't notice, maybe you do. I know I notice because I think I'm just sensitive to it. Oh, River Chick 23, I'm so glad you kept me that little comment. I am in chicken and dumpling heaven. I found no other product near as good as this other than pot stickers, but I just put everything. I could eat this plain out of the can. I even have a video I made ribeye and I ate it. I poured chicken and dumplings on top of it. You remember that? Oh. Other people are pouring sauteed mushrooms and sauce over there. I was pouring chicken and dumplings. So there's that. And speaking of comments, I have not been able to get to my comments for so long. I apologize. I like to do my responding every morning. When we have visitors or our schedules all uproar, I get all out of whack. So I'm gonna try to catch up on responding to comments. The thought that you guys are commenting and that you're not hearing back from me really is a downer for me, because I do love the interaction, and if it wasn't for you guys, I'd have no channel. So again, thank you. I appreciate your patience. I don't even get to read all my, sit down and enjoy reading my comments every morning. I have to read them like in a hurry throughout the day, and that's no fun. Both things are not fun. It's not fun that I'm not responding, and it's not fun for me that I can't sit down, relax, and enjoy the comments by themselves. But okay, so we're pretty much back to normal now. Holiday people aren't coming in and out anymore, so I can kind of get back to my routine. Also, they're eliminating messaging. They said, by the end of this month, there'll be no more messaging options. If you notice, you have a option to send comment or a private message. So I guess people weren't utilizing that, so that's going to be removed. And they said if you need to contact the person, you just have to go through email. And I should probably check email. I get so involved with you guys in the comments. I never check email. I need to do that. So we'll be having a lot of chicken and dumpling lunches. So the focus really won't be as much as the what am I eating today, because it'll be the same old chicken and dumplings. But I'm going to be showing you different ways to eat it. This is really delicious. I could have poured the whole can of green olives in there. It would have been perfect. I'm eyeballing my pantry. I have a can of black olives. Basil leaves were delicious. I could put a whole thing of basil in there, fresh basil. That'd be really good. Little strips of cut up meat. That'd be good in there. You know, I still have some leftover that rib roast from that recipe video I did. Oh, that'd be good. Put that in there.